Well, this is part three of the grow bed build series, and today we're going to be working some more on the trough sections. A couple days ago, my father-in-law came over and he helped me rip a whole bunch of plywood down. Now, I know I've mentioned this before, that these grow beds are going to be carrying a lot of weight. They're going to have roughly a foot of water sitting on top of them. So we really want to make them as strong as we possibly can. So the design of these grow beds with these plywood sides kind of looks like this if you look at it along the end. So we have the beam across the bottom, beam across the top, plywood in the middle. This sort of makes an asymmetrical I-beam, which will be able to carry a lot of weight. In order to get it to be as strong as possible, we're going to glue these on. We really want to get a good glue joint, so we're going to glue them and then screw them. And then horizontally this way, this thing's going to carry a lot of weight, and it's going to keep these grow beds from bowing in this direction. all four of these done. Got them all glued and screwed together. And they're pretty heavy, so I think I'm gonna try and enlist a little bit of help. See if I can get somebody to help me carry them out there to the pasture and get them set up on the legs. Well, I got some help out and I got all the grow beds placed onto the legs. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure the legs are nice and level and screw everything together. I think that's going to wrap it up for this part. We've managed to get, with a little help, the grow beds out here. Got everything screwed together. We've got the ends screwed on. The only thing we have left now is to get the decking put in and the insulation, and then the liner installed. I'm waiting on the liner. Got it ordered. Hopefully it'll be here sometime next week. And we'll get this thing wrapped up and then start installing the plumbing and get this thing running. That's it. Call it a day.